This video has been produced in the framework of the International Teacheress Project, which aims to promote the implementation of Managed Aquifer Recharge, or MAR, as a nature-based solution for sustainable water resources management in Latin America. The shortages of precipitation in the Brazilian semi-arid regions and ever-increasing water demand represent a threat for rural communities who are dependent upon agriculture, affecting crop yield, food security, and livelihoods. Therefore, it is a priority to adopt simple, low-cost, and easily applicable technologies such as subsurface dams. In several communities from the states of Pernambuco, Paraíba, Bahia, Ceará, and Rio Grande do Norte, they have been constructed across streams and valleys. They allow rainwater to be stored underground during the rainy season and to raise the groundwater table through an impermeable transverse wall. Then, the water is recovered during the dry season. Although easy to apply, the construction has to comply with some technical requirements. For example, the sediment must be predominantly sandy to enhance infiltration. And when built on a stream, the construction site must be at the narrowest part of the riverbed to maximize water capture and minimize cost. As a result of the subsurface dams, the production of maize, beans, and rice has increased, and the quality of fruits has improved. The increased production has secured food for the families, improving also their income after selling the production surplus. The dams also promoted environmental benefits, such as soil conservation or restoration, headwaters recovery, and groundwater replenishment. Nonetheless, in some cases, depending on the influent water or on the local conditions, the stored water might become unsuitable for irrigation due to high salinity. And given the multiple condition of sites where this MAR technique is applied, monitoring strategies need to be adequate to maintain the efficiency of the dams. The main disadvantages of this technique are that the interventions in natural groundwater flow might have a negative impact on downstream areas, and their cost can be up to $1,300 if using heavy machinery. Finally, we would like to thank all the project's funding institutions.